Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this live coverage of Hextech's Selene 3 mission launch. We are at 7 minutes and counting until launch time. For tonight's launch, Hextech is using the Selene 3.3 rocket, and we're placing a science payload into a translunar trajectory for a flyby, a low flyby of the moon in 5 days. And just a quick rundown of what to expect tonight. And we are approximately 6.5 minutes until liftoff. And the Selene 3 launch timeline looks something like this. At T-minus 15 seconds, the vehicle will switch to internal power and internal guidance, and the Polaris rocket is responsible for all functions at that point. At T-minus 5 seconds, we will have main sequence start and main engine ignition. And then at T-minus 0, we will, of course, lift off. At T-plus 2 minutes and 20 seconds, approximately, we will have separation of the payload fairings, exposing the payload. And at T-plus 2 minutes and 28 seconds, we will begin the staging sequence. At this point, the first stage will be shut down and separated from the vehicle, and the second stage will start up. At T plus 6 minutes and 45 seconds approximately, we should have the vehicle in orbit and begin payload deployment. The next major milestone for the mission will be at T plus 38 minutes and 47 seconds, at which point the spacecraft will modify its attitude in preparation for the translunar injection, or TLI burn. And that burn will begin at T plus 39 minutes and 48 seconds. And then the last major milestone for tonight's coverage will be at 1 hour, 2 minutes roughly into flight, at which point the deployed payload will adjust its attitude for proper alignment of the solar panels and deploy its science package in preparation for its mission. After that, tonight's coverage will end, and we will pick up the coverage again in approximately 5 days when the payload has reached the moon. We are now T-minus 4.5 minutes until launch. Everything is looking good. T-minus 3 minutes and counting. Everything continues to look okay with the vehicle. T-minus 2 minutes and counting. T-minus 60 seconds until launch. We are in final countdown. T-minus 30 seconds. T-minus 15 seconds, vehicle is now on internal power and guidance. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, give main sequence start in 3, 2, 1, liftoff. Liftoff of the Polaris rocket. Rocket has cleared the tower. And beginning roll program. Seconds into launch and everything continues to look good. Waiting for the vehicle to begin its pitch program, and pitch program has begun. Flight. All three main engines continue to operate as expected. Velocity approaching 400 meters per second. Altitude 10 kilometers. Vehicle is now traveling over 1 kilometer per second, out to 37 kilometers, downrange distance of 15 kilometers from the Space Center. Two minutes into flight, everything continues to look good. Vehicle now traveling 2 kilometers per second. 45 kilometers downrange, altitude approaching 70 kilometers, and preparing for payload fairing separation. To have staging operation a bit earlier than expected. We're going to have to check the telemetry on that. and see if we're going to have any problems with orbit. Did not see any, did not notice any issues with the main engine, so at this point, not quite sure what happened. Vehicle also seems to be in a slightly lazy, unintended roll. The flight controllers here continuing to monitor the vehicle. Trajectory is lower than expected. I'm just looking to see if the second stage guidance will compensate accordingly. Okay, so it appears that the second stage guidance was able to compensate for the earlier failure. We are into a much lower orbit than originally intended, but we will continue with the mission and hopefully everything will work out. The payload is now being deployed and will be aligning itself for a proper orbit. Final parking orbit is 270 kilometers by 150 kilometers, much lower than originally intended. Okay, just to recap here, we do have successful deployment of the payload. However, due to some problems occurred in the first stage, we are into a slower or lower than intended orbit. Spacecraft has, however, aligned itself for the coast period, which will bring us to the TLI up at approximately 39 minutes into flight, about 30 minutes from now. There is some concern here that the lower-than-intended orbit is going to cause problems with the calculated translunar injection burn. However, there is a possibility that the spacecraft's onboard guidance will be able to compensate for the changes. And we will find out, as I said, in approximately 30 minutes when that burn occurs. And commentary will resume at that point. You're approximately 5 minutes away from the translunar injection burn. Just a recap of earlier activity during this launch. We did have some issues with the first stage. Haven't reviewed all the data yet, but it looks like we had an early engine shutdown during the first stage, which left the spacecraft into a final orbit of a much lower altitude than desired. So far, though, the mission is still a go. We are looking forward to the programmed translunar injection burn here in just a few minutes, at which point we will determine if the spacecraft's own guidance can accommodate or account for the deviation from the plan. Once again, we are looking at TLI here in about 5 minutes. Okay, everyone, we are back now, just about a minute away from the spacecraft's planned translunar injection maneuver. This maneuver, if successful, will place the spacecraft on a transfer trajectory for the moon. We are awaiting that burn now to see if the spacecraft's guidance can make up for the lower than expected orbit that was obtained due to a first stage engine failure. In just a few months now, we should be seeing the spacecraft orientate itself for that burn. And there we go. Spacecraft is now orientating for the translunar burn. Okay, spacecraft is now beginning its burn. Has ullaged the fuel in the tank and the Agena has lit. A good light of the Agena transstage engine, or transfer engine rather, and TLI burn has begun. Burn will take approximately 2 minutes. Approximately a minute and 45 seconds of that will be burned with the Agena engine. And then the spacecraft will shut off the engine and switch to using RCS to fine-tune its approach to the moon. It is at this stage where the spacecraft's guidance can account for changes in the orbit, such as the problem we have right now. So we're just waiting to see how that burn works out. Okay, and the Agena engine has shut down. Spacecraft is now fine-tuning its approach to the moon using its onboard RCS. And now ground controllers are watching the telemetry for a capture with the moon. And they're indicating now that we do have a proper capture with the moon. Perihelion of 12.7 million meters and dropping. At this point, the spacecraft's guidance is doing its best to fine-tune the approach despite the differences in its initial burn. Perihelion is continuing to drop at 11.7 11 million meters and dropping. And 10 million meters. Nine million meters. Eight million meters and continuing to lower. Okay, ground control is reviewing the data now, and we do have a successful TLI burn with a periselene of just under 4 million meters. Looks like the spacecraft's guidance was able to account for the lower than intended orbit, so Selene 3 is on her way to the moon. Next major operation now will occur in approximately 15 minutes, and the spacecraft orientates itself for solar panel and payload solar panel optimization and payload deployment. Hello, everyone, and we're back with you for one last time during tonight's coverage of the Selene 3 mission. The Selene 3 spacecraft is now over 4.5 million meters away from the Earth as it continues on its lunar coast towards the Moon. At 5 million meters, coming up here in just a few moments, the spacecraft will be orientating itself, essentially spinning itself around so that the solar panels are pointed towards the Sun so that it can continue to receive electrical charge throughout its lunar coast. At that point, it will also be deploying an array of scientific instruments, which will be used once it reaches the Moon. And despite a problem with the engine during our launch, the Polaris 3.3 rocket has successfully delivered Selene 3 on its way to the Moon, in which it will arrive in approximately 5 days. And we're coming up on that last maneuver now here in just a few moments. And now the spacecraft's attitude is changing, and since science instruments are being deployed. And Selene 3 has successfully readjusted its attitude so that the solar panels will be facing the Sun. The Moon is almost directly into the Sun at this point, so it can get lots of charge on the way over. Science instruments have been deployed, and spacecraft is ready for lunar operations in approximately 5 days. Tonight's mission has been a success despite some early problems, and we will end coverage here, but we will pick up coverage again in approximately 5 days. Friday, I believe, is when the next scheduled coverage begins for its flyby of the Moon. Thank you. Have a great night and good luck.